quite a few others. Well, joining me now to take up the what appear to be delusions of the Republican establishment, the push for tax reform, and much more, Matt Schlapp. He is the chairman of the American Conservative Union. Matt, good to have you with us. Let's start with Defense Secretary Mattis, first of all, genuflecting to a ignorant senator who is sitting there telling him that it's a yes or no question.
Boy, I think it's time for a cabinet meeting, Lou. You know, you had the president tweeting about Rex Tillerson with North Korea. Now you have the Secretary of Defense. You know, the only thing I could say in parsing that is they said, right now, is it okay that we're in the deal? And he said, yes. I sure hope that by the time we get to this deadline that's looming, where the Iran deal should be decertified by the president, that his whole team is on board with that decision.
Yeah, I think parsing your parse, if I may, he said in the national interest, and it is decidedly in the judgment of the folks I respect most, not.
That's right.
Your opinion of it?
My opinion is that the Iran
yes or no?
I agree with you.
That's a joke.
I agree with you. and I never even talked to Angus King. So there you go.
What a beauty he is, huh? Unbelievable. Mattis, how can you put up with a Tillerson doing, apparently went rogue in Asia, decided he was going to lay out the future of the administration's foreign policy. General Mattis, not for the first time, just a little too cute by half.
Yeah, and I think the thing about Donald Trump, which is jarring to people, Lou, is that when, and I don't know what he's going to say in response to what the Secretary of Defense just said today, but he tends to take his displeasure with his cabinet secretaries public. So it'll be interesting to see, is there a woodshed moment done in private, or is there a public chastisement? In either case, something needs to happen.
Yeah, this is strange. I have never seen a president treated so poorly by those he gave extraordinary authority as secretaries of the departments in his administration. This is bad form on their part. And frankly, I consider it ignorant behavior at the very best on their part.
And no more clear campaign promise. No, there were others that were clear as well, but no more clear than the fact that he was going to get out of this terrible Iran deal.
Yeah, it's striking. It is also striking that the Senate Leadership Committee deciding that Steve Bannon's threats were overstated in terms of the consequences for, in behalf of and the success of Judge Roy Moore in Alabama. There are, 17, 18 other seats that are vulnerable by some measures. How in the world could these people be so arrogant and indifferent to the lessons that they are witnessing in the shift in American politics?
I think it was Mark Twain who said something along the lines of, there's nothing more dangerous than believing in something that isn't so. And for these Republicans who believe that what happened in Alabama is an aberration, I have to believe they're going to have to do a lot more losing until they realize when you imprint a candidate with this Congress, which has failed to implement these major campaign promises that people put them here to implement, when you imprint a candidate with that, that candidate is severely weakened, and I don't think they realize that, which means I think these primaries are a very real threat to them.
Oh, I don't think there's any question about it, and I think only a loser like McConnell would be presiding over a Senate and a party apparatus that is suddenly clucking about the success of Judge Roy Moore and the failure of his personal 24 million dollars he pumped into that campaign in Alabama. This guy should be licking his wounds and be just a little contrite, even a little modest, but instead trying to deny what is a clear shift, and that is with the election of this president, Judge Roy Moore, the success in four other special elections. Who is Mitch McConnell? I mean, it's extraordinary.
I think that what this story shows, Lou, is that also, the political operatives that are invested in the status quo are afraid that the money trail will be upset as well, because their donors believe that they can win these races even when their candidate is unpopular, with the shock and awe of outrageous amounts of money.
How strong is Steve Bannon and his group that he's put together? How strong are they?
Well, Lou, it's pretty strong. You know why? Because it's a combination of two things. Steve has access to a real platform and to real funds. But when you put that in combination with the fact that grassroots Republicans and conservatives and a lot of Trump supporters who are independents are very, very frustrated at the Republican Congress. There is nothing they're more frustrated at politically than the failure of the Republican Congress, especially these senators who lied about what they would do if they got the majority. They are fit to be tied.
And one hopes that he doesn't squander all of his attention on the Senate and hopefully turns to the House and finds new leadership there as well.
There's a lot of targets out there, and I do think for Speaker Ryan and for Leader McConnell, their political necks are on the line on this tax bill. It's got to deliver on stimulating this economy, and they've got to get it done. And by the way, Lou, I hate to say this, it is not going to be easy.
Nothing is in either the House or the Senate, it seems. It seems like it should be, but certainly hasn't proved to be. Matt Schlapp, as always, good to have you with us and to talk with you.